Good morning, YouTube. Welcome to another installment in my solar power series. Unboxing videos seem to be popular on YouTube, so here goes mine. I received this box in the mail last week. This was purchased from eBay seller, solarseller.com website, and the return address is John Drake Services Incorporated. Let's see what's inside. Looks to be pretty nicely packed. We've got some information there, a bunch of packing peanuts. And here's the good stuff. This appears to be a Bogart Engineering TM2030RV Trimetric Battery Monitoring System. I purchased the system with a 100 amp shunt, since that is about the maximum I expect to pull with a 1000 watt inverter. Usually I'm only using a few hundred watts except for starting motor loads. So inside, looks like this is the Trimetric display, and then here is the current shunt. Depending on how I connect it, the meter can read all sorts of battery system parameters. I'll be connecting it up to look at only the batteries, placing this shunt in the negative bus between the batteries and the loads. I'll place a link to the Trimetric webpage so you can see all the parameters it can measure. My main goal is to be able to measure what is going into and out of my battery bank on a day-to-day basis. My solar charge controller shows me charging current and voltage and has a crude state of charge display, but that's it. The Trimetric logs current and voltage over time into and out of the battery bank and uses that to calculate an accurate state of charge. As my solar power system loads grow, I need to know how many amp hours I'm pulling from the batteries overnight so I can know when I'm getting to the limit of how deeply I want to discharge them. I only have some rough estimates of what the batteries supply overnight, so once I hook this thing up, I should know exactly. The only problem is I can't hook this up at the present time, as I need to do some major rewiring on my battery bank. So sit tight until I can get that underway, and then I'll be back when I'm ready to connect this to the rewired battery bank. Well, I couldn't wait to get the battery bank rewired, so I installed the meter shunt temporarily down here. I found an extra flat ground strap and used that to tie the shunt to the battery negative bus. Then the cables for the inverter and charge controller attached to the other side of the shunt. I chose this 100 amp, 100 millivolt shunt initially, as it'll give me readings down to 10 milliamps, or one more digit than my charge controller or clamp-on ammeter shows. So I set the Trimetric reader to use the smaller shunt, and set up the battery voltage and current readings to match my charge controller. You can see here it reads voltage, there's the current battery charging current, percent full, and then you can also do hold the button down, and this will show you basically the amp hours from full. So it's 0.08 amp hours from full, and that gives you the 100% state of charge. And the Trimetric meter uses a combination of the charging voltage
and the charging current. And basically, if the charging voltage is above the threshold you set and the charging current is below the threshold you set, and it stays there for a time, which you can set up as well, that determines that the battery is fully charged. And then it monitors the current flowing into and out of the battery bank, along with a charging efficiency parameter to determine how many amp hours the battery is from full. And you can program the battery bank amp hour capacity as another parameter. And with this, you get a fairly accurate state of charge reading. It's not based upon voltage and temperature, but rather how many amp hours have been withdrawn from the battery bank. The advantage here is that the reading is continuous and can be taken with the batteries connected to a load. The traditional temperature and voltage-based state of charge is done in an open circuit and after the battery has been sitting for a while for the voltage to stabilize. In the first few days of testing, I see my battery bank is in the 90 to 92% state of charge in the morning, or in other words, my overnight loads are using 18 to 20 amp hours of power. I see about 1.3 amps of load from the attic fans and the TV amplifiers that are running right now. This is good to know, as I can double the amount of constant loads and keep the batteries above an 80% state of charge. With separate current readings for the inverter, the battery bank, and the charge controller output, I can really see what is happening with my system. So stay tuned for an upcoming video where I show some of these test results. And I'll cover the battery bank rewiring in an upcoming video. If you have any questions, feel free to join the conversation in the comment section below. Be sure to rate and share this video, and subscribe to this channel for future updates. Thanks for watching.